Okay, so now in this lecture, we're going to discuss some of the various peak shapes that you may visualize on a chromatogram and how the partition coefficient factors into the Gaussian symmetric versus asymmetric peak shapes. So this is sort of a touch of reality. In real columns, as the concentration of solute in the mobile phase increases, oftentimes the concentration of solute in the stationary phase changes. And what this does is it leads to asymmetric peaks. So the ideal peak below is peak B, or this is a symmetric and Gaussian shape, which has well-defined mathematical parameters such as standard deviation, variance, peak width, and from this peak, we can have a very high efficiency or a good separation. So if you consider the asymmetric peaks, peaks A and C here, these are due to a partition coefficient that is variable. So if you consider one solute in the column, the partition coefficient for that solute, if it's not a constant, then it's going to lead to an asymmetric peak. If the K part is a constant, then that's ideal, and that will lead to the symmetric Gaussian peak. So let me go through each of these and describe the origin of the peak shape. So for the first one, we see this sort of gradual rise, followed by a maximum and then an abrupt fall after the maximum. So it's sort of shifted to the right, or the center of the peak is shifted to the right relative to the symmetric Gaussian peak. This is known as overloading, or overloading is the cause of this gradual rise and abrupt fall. Overloading is also known as fronting, or the front part of the peak sort of rises gradually. Now, the origin of this is that the partition coefficient increases with an increasing concentration of solutes in the mobile phase. Okay, or as we add more solute to the column and the separation goes on with time, then an increasing amount of solute becomes soluble in the stationary phase. Or you can think about it as having more solute in the column leads to a higher affinity for stationary phase. So as more and more solute sticks to the stationary phase, right? Or as the concentration of mobile phase solute increases, the concentration of stationary phase solute increases, that's what causes K part to go up, right? Recall that K part is defined as the concentration of solute in the stationary phase over the concentration of solute in the mobile phase. Now, the reason that more and more solute sticks is because the stationary phase now begins to appear like the solute because it's covered with all this excess solute. And remember that if the stationary phase is basically looking like the solutes, then more solute will stick to it because like dissolves like. Okay, so on a plot below, we'll describe what the isotherm looks like and visualize K part, but please just know the definition of fronting as being this gradual rise followed by an abrupt fall. And that's because as we keep adding more solute to the column and there's more in the mobile phase, more of it will stick to the stationary phase. And as the stationary phase no longer looks like the stationary phase molecules, but looks like the solute instead, more solute will stick because like dissolves like. Okay. So the ideal peak, right, or the Gaussian peak is peak B. And remember that this was a symmetrical peak with well-defined standard deviation and peak width, etc. For this peak, K part is a constant. And that's really the ideal scenario. In real columns, it's hard to have a constant partition coefficient with large amounts of solute that are separated in the column. So as the concentration in the mobile phase increases, then the concentration in the stationary phase increases as well, but it does so linearly or with a constant slope, okay? Where above is this mobile phase solute increases for an overloading scenario, the stationary phase solute increases non-linearly. Okay, so what this says is that for the Gaussian peak, in theory, it doesn't matter how much solute you apply to the column, it will have the same partition coefficient no matter what. So the third case is known as tailing, peak C. And tailing is described as having this very abrupt and early rise to reach the maximum point on the peak, but then a gradual fall, or this is a tail to the curve. And tailing is caused by the scenario where small quantities of solute, right, when the concentration of solute in the mobile phase is low, these stick to the stationary phase with higher affinity or are more soluble in the stationary phase than if you load the column with a bunch of solutes. Once again, for this K part will decrease as the concentration in the mobile phase increases. Okay, whereas for overloading, K part increased with an increase in concentration in the mobile phase. So this is once again a non-linear relationship of concentration in the stationary phase versus concentration in the mobile phase. So as you add more and more solute to the mobile phase, not as much of it can stick because only small quantities of solute are going to have a high affinity or a high solubility in the stationary phase. So the way that we're going to sort of model these is with an isotherm. An isotherm is taken into constant temperature. And recall that the partition coefficient, right, which is the concentration of solute in the stationary phase relative to concentration of solute in the mobile phase, those are going to be the dependent and independent variables here. So if it's a linear relationship, right, then K part, which is the slope, is simply constant. So this is peak B. if we compare it to peak A, or overloading, is we add more solute to the mobile phase. Now, stationary phase begins to look like the solute, and more solute dissolves, or like dissolves like, and then we get this curve above the linear curve. Or you can remember that overloading is on top. All right, this is also known as fronting. That was peak A above, where K parts increases, or the slope increases with increasing concentration of solute in the mobile phase. The other case is below the partition coefficient, or below the ideal partition coefficient, which was constant. So this is peak C, okay, or the tailing peak, where at small quantities of solute, then it's pretty much linear and ideal. But as the solute, as at high concentrations out here, okay, those large quantities of solute are less soluble, or they go through the column, and therefore K part decreases, or the concentration of solute in the stationary phase decreases with increasing concentration in the mobile phase. So you should be able to sketch each of these peak shapes above, and you should know each term that corresponds to the peak and the origin of each cause. Of course, generally in mathematics, we're going to focus on the Gaussian scenario, okay, where the statistical parameters of the curve are well understood. However, you should also be able to take those peak shapes and apply them to the isotherm and label each as either overloading versus ideal versus tailing. So for more practice with Gaussian peaks and column chromatography in general, you can visit Unit 2 of my analytical course guide at chemguides.com.